So our entertainment continuing, and we will have the Agility Championships finals coming up. Three classifications, the small, the medium, and large dogs. And the course, as you can see, although the lights dimmed, the course has already been set by our judge tonight. I'm going to be commentating on this Agility Championship with Graham Partridge. And with him now, we can take a look at the course that the dogs are going to be confronting.
Promises to be a very exciting final. Course has been set by our judge, Mr. Roger Griffin. And it is a course full of twists and turns. Jump, dog walk, and then they turn sharp left over an obstacle. They come around that one and have to pull in. That's difficult. Into the far end of the tunnel, and then they've got a long straight. Jump, A-frame, long jump into the tunnel. They have to avoid the jump as they come out of the tunnel into the weaving poles. They have to go towards the tunnel but avoid it. And they go around the outside of the box, back into the tunnel, and then it's tunnel, tunnel. Seesaw, point of control. Back into the far end of the tunnel, they come out for the last two obstacles and hopefully a clear round and the winning round.
Well, that's what the handlers and the dogs will have to go through for this Agility Championship final, which, it's worth saying, Graham, is the absolute pinnacle of the sport. This is the one that they all want to win.
They do all went to it. It's the culmination of four fantastic days of fun and serious agility competitions. What you're seeing here is the best of British agility, and in fact the best of international agility, because we have had lots of fantastic international agility. But this is the one that they really want to win. They want to win the championship title of Crufts 2016.
I think while we've got time as well, just nice to give a point of thanks for our judges through the week's competition as well. Roger Griffin today, but two others as well in the run-up to this.
Yes, we've had Cathy Keith and Gary Murphy done fantastic jobs. They judged the first 3 days, and then we have a championship judge who is just here for the Sunday, and it is the culmination of anyone's judging career. I was very fortunate to be and proud and honoured to be asked to judge this a couple of years ago. And I can tell you that Roger will be just a little bit nervous out there now, because he wants the course to run. He's designed it. They will have seen it about an hour ago. They would have had the course maps. They've walked it, and they now have to remember the route and how they're going to handle it. And not only that, they've got to try and guide their dogs around. It is not easy.
Absolutely not. And the judge will be coming in shortly. And while we await them to actually make their official entrance, let's just have another look at that course. Graham, talk us through it once more.
Starts tired dog walk. They must make contact on both ends of that. Then they go over the, and they come around the wing. And then you can see they've got to go back towards the A-frame but avoid it, and then take the opposite end of the tunnel. Now it's fairly straightforward over the A-frame. Long jump into the tunnel, straight into the weaves. And now that's the difficult bit, avoiding the entrance to the tunnel and then turning around. More twists and turns. The handlers will want to be on the inside of any circle that the dogs are taking. Far end of that tunnel. They'll move across and pick up the dog on the left-hand side as it comes out. And it's easy.
Easy when you look at that. But, of course, there are points at which penalties are likely to be imposed. They've got to go through the weaves cleanly, we all know about that. But I think it's important as well to talk about the A-frame, the dog walk, and the seesaw.
Yeah, the seesaw, it does test the dog's confidence, because normally a dog would, natural instinct would be to jump off it as soon as it started to move. So not only have they got to make contact with the white bit at the beginning, they've got to go up, they've got to go over the pivot point to avoid a refusal, they've got to tip it. It has to be touching the ground before they get off, and they have to make contact with the white area. So
if they leap off, five faults.
If they leap off before the contact point and after the pivot point, yes.
Well, there is Roger Griffin, the man who has designed that course that we've looked at, a retired BT engineer from Maidenhead in Berkshire. Masses of experience in obedience and indeed in agility. And he says he's been hooked on it now for more than 20 years.
Great judge, great competitor, and the culmination of his judging career here at Crufts.
Well, we're going to be having the small dogs first of all. And there is Anne Edwards with Roxy, our first competitor, a Pomeranian Collie cross, 10 years old, Roxy Rocket from Dorking, owned by Rosemary Hampshire, a rescue dog originally.
10 years of age, but still doing remarkably well. Just picking up a fault there, so they're running with five faults, and that's going to be another five faults for going to the left of the weaving pole. Got to go to the right, the first one. So picking up a couple of faults here, and the nerves I know are going to be jangling for Anne.
Through the tunnel, now through the collapsible tunnel, not phased one bit by that, and you see what's required there for the seesaw, and no penalty points imposed there. And coming up towards the final hurdle, and 43.801, but with 10 faults.
Fortunately, picking up a few faults there, just to stress that in order to be awarded the title of Crufts champion and get the dog's title, you have to get round the course clear. You can't win it with any faults at all.
We've got Fifi, the toy poodle now, 5 years old, from Usselby near Market Raisin in Lincolnshire, with Hayley Tindall. Fifi had operations on both knees in 2012, and you can hear from the reaction of the crowd, they already love to see this little dog who is really scampering round.
It is, it's covering the ground so quickly, the legs are almost a blur as it's going round, so now she's got to just concentrate, make sure it goes into these weaving poles correctly. They must be completed correctly before it goes on.
Look at that, the crowd love that, slaloming her way through. And Fifi is really flying now, coming up towards the closing stages, through the collapsing tunnel, up towards the seesaw, and I think that's okay. Through the tunnel once more, and coming round towards the final jump, over she goes, and clearing 43.008.
What a great effort, isn't she happy? They're playing tug with the dog, that's its reward. No time wait, scampers off the end of the dog walk there. Lovely tight turns, look at the way this dog's having so much fun.
Daniel Croxford, who's a 17-year-old handler from Whitstable, with a Sheltie cross, 8-year-old Bess. Bess, he says, is a really special little dog. Competed internationally as well as being part of Team GB in 2014. And I'm afraid to say that five faults have already come his way.
Such a shame. So the championship title won't be going to him. Daniel's going to be representing Great Britain as part of the Kennel Club junior team, going to the European Championship, sponsored by the Kennel Club for the first time this year. So good luck to them.
Listen to Bess happily yapping her way around this course. She's just loving every moment. Through into the tunnel, now to the collapsing tunnel, now moving on towards the seesaw. Nicely done. And over the remaining hurdles, through the tunnel, one more, and then the final flight. Over we go, and that would have been a really quick time. 39.564, but sadly, those five early faults.
Good time, but as you can see, clearly missing the contact there and picking up five faults.
This is Bernadette Bay with Zaz, a 7-year-old Sheltie from Fittleworth in West Sussex. Zaz has won Cruft Championships, Cruft Singles and the British Open multiple on many times. This is another dog which likes to make a bit of racket on the way round, but you don't get penalised for that.
No, you can make as much noise as you want. This dog is a bit noisy, but it's also fantastically quick. Very deceptive partnership, this.
Represented GB at European and World Championships and has won a silver and a bronze medal, and going well. Look at the time to beat, and it looks as though Zaz is right on schedule. That's good, I think, on the seesaw, round into the tunnel for the last time. This is going to be quick, and he's going to absolutely smash that fastest time. 35.009, that is the one to beat.
Wowee, what a great run by Bernadette. You can always rely on her to give 110%. Gets the very best out of her dogs.
Alan Bray from Milton Keynes with Tatiana. Tatty, he calls her, a miniature poodle, 7 years old, and he was a judge last year in this event, now showing exactly what he's capable of producing as a competitor. Nice sharp turn, round over the hurdle towards the tunnel for the first time. Off goes Alan, giving the dog plenty of opportunity to set off in pursuit, and that's good.
Fantastically keen miniature poodle, handled by Alan's got lots of experience. He knows exactly what it's to do, leaving the dog in the weave to do it by itself, and now he comes into this tight little section
beautifully. round through the tunnel, now to the collapsing tunnel. Onto the seesaw, wait, and good again. Now, just that final concentration. It's going to be outside the last time, but it's going to be quick. Over the final flight, 39.556, moving into second place.
Second place there for Alan. Knew he was going to have to just give it all he could to try and beat Bernadette Bay. But again, the dog just picking up the tunnel. Very clear, just leaves off and trusts the dog to follow him. What a good dog.
They've got to really go for it now to try and set a new fastest time. Lucy Osborne's turn from Lincoln. This is Fling, 3 years old. Lucy says that Fling is a crazy ball of fun. And they've got to really go for this. Demonstrative in her instructions and vocal as well. And the little dog is responding.
It is, and if anybody can beat Bernadette, it's going to be her. This dog has really come on in the last 12 months, only 3 years of age. Just look at it go, and Lucy's going to give this 110%.
Once again, the legs are blurring. This little dog, pretty as a picture, going through the collapsing tunnel. Now over the seesaw. Was that okay? Yes, no penalties there. Two more to go. It's going to be close towards the final and just outside. 36.494, but that's good enough for second place for Lucy Osborne and Fling.
Great effort for Lucy Osborne and Fling, member of the Team GB squad this year, represented Great Britain last year, and a dog and handler partnership with a great future.
Dana Kirst from Gala Shields with Kayla, a six-year-old Jack Russell. Competes for Scotland and in the agility team for the GB squad. Just trying to get the dog to concentrate absolutely. It's all about working together as a team over the dog walk. Has to touch on the way down. Look how quick this dog is. Really moves across the ground. There's and yapping happily all the way.
Can be. These little dogs sometimes can be deceptive because they move very quickly and scurry. They look a little bit faster, but this dog is quick. Can he get the entrance to the weaving poles? Yes, he can.
This is going very, very well at this stage for Donna. If it can stay clean, coming towards the tunnel, round and through into the collapsible tunnel, it might be on the cards this. Oh, may have leapt off the seesaw, yet, and that's going to be five faults. What a shame, because look at the time. That would have been 35. That would have been good enough for second place, but I'm afraid to say, faults on the seesaw.
The smaller the dog, the further they have to go to the end to get it to tip, and that's what happened. It wasn't touching the ground before the dog got off.
Here's Bonnie Quick with Shelley, a three-year-old Jack Russell Collie Cross from Wellington in Somerset. This is her debut at Crufts, Bonnie's younger dog. Last year at 2 years old, she became one of the youngest ever agility champions, winning four tickets in quick succession. Oh, leaping off there a bit too early. Paws weren't on the white section of that dog walk. And so five faults there. Real spring in the stride, though. Once again, leaping off the A-frame, and that signalled as well. And that's another five faults, so that's 10 at this point. But moving nicely, really nicely, through the weaves. Bit of a pity that to pick up those points, though.
It was an agility round. She did hold the dog on the contacts, and that was the reason why. She knows the dog will, if she's not really firm with it, get off. Yeah, that's what you should have done in the first place. She's just reminding him. But well done, Bonnie. The dog's very young. It's only three. She will be back. I absolutely guarantee that. So here we go. Yeah, that's probably the easiest decision that the judge is going to have to make all day, I would think. So now what's happening is that is the end of the small championship. And that is the standalone event by itself. And now we come on to the Crufts medium championship. They're just raising the height.
Confirmation of the result. Bernadette Bay winning the small dog with Zaz, 35.009, Lucy Osborne in second place from Lincoln with Fling, 36.494. Alan Bray taking third.
Yeah, I got
Gemma Haycock with Ruby, a six-year-old staffy from Northampton. Simply Red Rubes. We're moving now into the medium-sized dogs. And we've seen Simply Red Rubes earlier in the week, and we know that this little staffy can really move, and the crowd love it as well. Real little characters, these dogs.
Love to see this pairing do well here at Cross. And unfortunately, as I say that, they pick up five faults, but they've got some absolutely fantastic dogs to come after us. So being the first dog to go, it's always really difficult.
Good line. Leapt off a little bit too soon, as you saw, and we'll see that in the replay in just a moment. And that's why those five faults were imposed. And coming around now towards the finish, that would have been a really good round, Shane.
Good effort, well done, Gemma. And she's, like she always says, she's going to be taking the best dog home. And here we go, over the A-frame, just leaving it away. And again, the dog clearly missing the white bit. And that's what we want, accuracy and safety.
Jennifer Kent with Max, the five-year-old Patterdale Terrier from Luncarty in Perth, Scotland. Part of the Scottish team for the last 2 years. She admits that Max still has lots to learn, but he's a good jumper. May not be the quickest dog, but it's all about line as well as sheer speed, as Graham has told us.
It is. It's also about getting the turns really, really tight. And as you say, the dog may not be the quickest, but it may well be that it's not too keen on running on this artificial grass. Most of our competitions, week in, week out, are held outside.
Jennifer urging Max on, wanting a little bit more time. You can see her encouraging the dog to move faster and faster.
And unfortunately, the dog picking up an elimination there out of the weaves. It took the wrong obstacle and it did the tunnel instead of doing the jump. And that, I think, probably is just a little bit of nerves, and it can get you. But she's getting a really great round of applause here, and as you can see, clapping her hands, keeping the dog happy.
This is where it went wrong. Through there. And that wasn't what was required. Heather McLean with Mooey, a nine-year-old working sheepdog from Scotland, Ayton in Berwickshire, to be precise. Mooey's had all sorts of health problems. She's had to have major operations, but back here, and Heather describes the dog as simply awesome. Nice start, very quickly away, and very precise over the dog walk as well, and coming round over. She's missed one, I'm afraid, and that's five faults. Had to go over there before going through the tunnel, and that's a shame.
It is. Just to remind everybody, to be awarded the Agility Challenge Certificate, you have to have a clear round. So unfortunately, that's going to put Heather and Super Mooey out of the running. But she'll carry on. She does tunnel, test of confidence going into the collapsible. Ooh, naughty little seesaw there, picking up another five.
So 10 faults. And so far, we're still waiting for our first clear round in this medium classification. Here's the first penalty. There, missed it.
Heather just started to move away. And then again, oh, you naughty little Mooey.
Here's Libby, nine-year-old crossbreed with Stephen Richardson from Carlisle. She's won 21 championship tickets and a silver medal at the World Agility Open last year. Really experienced dog and an experienced handler in Stephen. And thoroughly enjoying this, yapping happily into the tunnel and moving well.
Super successful little dog, this 9 years of age now. Still very, very competitive. And you can see winning a certificate this year as she comes down now. Tunnel's going to be the next thing.
Well, she ran a really tight line before those tunnels, and it's all being rewarded. Looks as though it's going to be clear. Only two more to get over. Here up towards the last hurdle. Over we go, 36.829. Nine-year-old Libby is our leader.
And that set the mark. You see Stephen crossing behind the dog in the weaves. The dogs did well to stay in them there. Plenty of clearance on these jumps. Nice turn following him to the finish. And they're both going to be very happy with that.
We like to see different breeds. This is a Nova Scotia duck tolling retriever called Rogue. 9 years old, Amanda Hampson is the handler from Stoke-on-Trent. Rogue's been to Crufts a number of times and apparently absolutely loves the atmosphere. Let's see if he can get around with a clear round. The time going for is 36.829. Looked to be moving quite as quickly as the last dog did, and I'm afraid to say has picked up five faults as well.
Yes, previous clear round, they're now having to push to try and get sub 37 seconds round here. This is one of the most consistent dogs you'll see on an agility circuit.
Oh, did that come off too quickly? No, no more faults have been given, I don't think. Perhaps a wee bit fortunately. Over we go, 38.204, but five faults.
Mandarin, she always does, coming out with a smile on her face. And as you can see, just about half an inch in it, but correctly given.
Sue Cooper with Mitzi, a four-year-old Yorkie cross from Oswestry. Dream dog, says Sue Cooper, and represented Great Britain and Germany of members of Team GB back in December. She had a litter of puppies. Oh, get it right, and went wide, took a wrong course, but no refusal, so no faults as yet, and really quick, spirited little dog. Did she go off too quickly on the dog walk? Not been given, though, and round through the weaves, and she's making up time here. It looks as though it's going to be quick. Towards the tunnel, moving through now to the collapsible tunnel. Keep an eye on that clock, it's got to be right here. It is, through now, with two to clear after the tunnel. It's going to be very close. Is it going to be fast enough? Not quite.
Oh,
37.444 and finishing in second place.
What a great effort. Now you see, this is very deceptive because this dog looked to be going really, really quickly. He must have lost at least a couple of seconds there, and that's where, unfortunately, it went out the window.
Well, Mitzi would have been right up there. This is Rebecca Sargent with Dolly from Warrington, a seven-year-old border collie. Both of them love crusts. And you can hear that Rebecca also doesn't shy away from giving vocal encouragement. Moving round towards the tunnel for the first time, and the dog, a nice happy bark. And you see the team, the time that they're going for. Ooh, it gets that right. Could be quick, this one, Graham.
This dog is quick, and if they can get it right, they're going to put themselves in with a really good chance of taking this title, which they would absolutely love.
Lovely tight turns, two tunnels now. Here's the collapsible up towards the seesaw. That's beautifully done. This is going to be quick. It could be on here. It most definitely is on. Towards the final hurdle, and it's the quickest time. 35.064. A new leader, Rebecca Sargent and Dolly. What a round.
It was well over a second and a half, and that's some margin. What a great round. This dog really does cover the ground well, and they are going to be absolutely ecstatic with that.
Linda Cummings from County Durham. This is Cooper, a six-year-old working sheepdog. Linda says that Cooper is one in a million. I've heard that one or two times. Over the dog walk now. Nicely done, very precise. Ooh, a bit wide on that turn. Now has to stop, be checked. He got it right though, didn't touch the dog. Not allowed to do that, only allowed to signal and guide. Over the A-frame, nicely.
Took the momentum out of the dog though, but she comes down into the weaves. This dog quick through the weaves. Just look at it going through those things. Oh, almost some confusion there, but she manages to keep it together. Now I think she's lost herself. She has, there was a moment's hesitation. She forgot where she was going. The heat got to her, as they say, and she took the wrong course. Such a shame.
Pity that, because Cooper was going well. Look at the speed through the weaves.
Just a little bit of confusion. She forgot where she was going. Then she thought she should be going in the tunnel, and then it's like, oh dear, I've forgotten.
Rebecca Sargent has 35.064 and clear. Natasha Wise with Dizzy. Dizzy, three times world champion, six times Olympia champion, second last year to Sean Illingworth, who didn't make the final. This dog could do it. That's good over the dog walk, but it needs to be quick. Very, very experienced handler, Natasha, just running a wee bit wide there, Graham.
Just a bit. She just needs to keep it clear and accurate here. The dog's got the natural speed to take this. And just look at the doctor in these wheel holes. Can't get through them quick enough, John.
Beautifully done. Again, just a little bit of a hesitation there, but okay. Through the tunnels now, and an eye on the clock to the seesaw. Has to allow it to touch the ground, which it did. And through the tunnel, it could be on, it's going to be close. Look at the clock, and there it is. By the narrowest of margins, Natasha Wise has gone clear, and she is the medium dog champion by fractions ahead of Rebecca Sargent. And don't they love the moment?
I'm sat here, as I say, goose pimples again. I cannot get enough of watching this dog and partnership. And just look at that face. As I say, not only is she just annoyingly brilliant, she's also the nicest person I think I've probably ever met, and she deserves everything she gets out of this. And I couldn't be happier for her. And I'm sure everybody in the country, certainly who's got any knowledge of agility, would support what I'm saying. She really is fantastic.
Natasha says that she's honoured to be Dizzy's owner and to compete with her. Coming up towards her 10th birthday now, but still there, top of the pile, ahead of Rebecca Sargent and Dolly. But look at those times. Bye, that was close.
It was. And that's why we use electronic timing rather than a stopwatch. It's that important that we get them down to thousandths of a second.
Course being adjusted now. This is the large dogs now. And we start off with Charlotte Harding and Scandal, a seven-year-old border collie. Fifth time at Crufts. Charlotte's been doing agility for 16 years. Had a silver in agility at the World Championships and a gold in 2015. And last year's winner, Charlotte Harding, coming in first here, could be setting a very quick time for the others to have to try and go for broke and try and match. And it's all clean so far.
She would just go for this. Nobody remembers who comes second here at Crufts. It's all about the win. And that's exactly what she's going to do.
Look at the speed of the dog, the acceleration as she came out of those tunnels, into the last tunnel now, and moving round towards the finish, lightning fast, 32.522, the big dog, a brilliant start, and clean all the way round, and a great time.
Brilliant start to the competition. It's always fantastic when the first dog to go sets a brilliant fast time. Now we're really going to see this competition heat up.
Well, they're going to have to go for broke now. Alan Short, the first to give it a go, with Bruce. Alan from Kirkcaldy in Scotland, a six-year-old border collie is Bruce. Scottish international, represented Great Britain as well at numerous international competitions. Alan says that Bruce is such a dedicated and driven dog. Well, he's sure going to have to drive now. He's not only going to have to be accurate, he's going to have to go like lightning. And I'm afraid to say he's already picked up 5 faults.
And that's what having someone set a really good time at the early on in the competition does to you. He knows that he would probably have to go as fast as he possibly could to actually stand a chance of winning. But he'll want to show off his Scottish skills.
And he'll want to show what might have been. Another bar comes down, I'm afraid, just mistiming the takeoff and picking up 5. Did come off the seesaw too quickly? No, says the judge. Well, it's good, but I'm afraid to say 10 faults, so it's not going to be the evening for Alan Short to triumph.
No, it won't. I'll just remind people that you cannot be awarded the agility certificate if you have any faults at all. You have to win it with a clear round.
Which is what Charlotte Harding delivered. Here's Bonnie Quick with Hayley, 8-year-old Kelpie cross collie from Wellington in Somerset. Achieved a lot more. She says that Hayley's achieved more than she could have wished for, and she thinks that she is just a great dog, this Kelpie collie cross. But they're going to have to fly now if they're going to get up with the very, very fast time, which has already been recorded.
No time wasted at all on the contact points here. She'll be going for it as well. She knows that she has to put in a near-perfect round.
What a good line that was. Through the tunnel, accelerating now. Keep an eye on that clock. 32.522 was really quick, and it's going to be outside that, but it's going to be fast towards the final hurdle. 34.464 into second place. Clear round.
Great round there, great running contacts. Just pauses a little bit, but not a lot of time lost there. And the same thing, just about getting a couple of pauses on that, but that's all you need.
Lauren Langman with Tiki, 7-year-old border collie from Okehampton. Lauren says Tiki is an awesome little dog. This is a second time at Crufts and loves the experience. And I'm afraid to say that Tiki, going for that very, very tight line, has brought down one of the bars.
He has, but Lauren will carry on. What we need to remember is we need to keep these positive experiences. The only time dogs know that they've gone wrong is when we tell them. Picking up 5 more faults in the weaves there.
So it's not going to be Lauren's evening here. But Tiki showing that she is a lovely dog and moving enthusiastically towards the end of the course. Just two more hurdles to go over. Here we go, and 10 faults. Good round, but not quite good enough.
But we have to remember that these are all dogs at the top of their game within the country. They've all won a challenge certificate within the last 12 months. So these are the best of the best we're seeing here today.
Dave Munnings with Boss, six-year-old Border Collie. They're from Newbury. Dave, an experienced handler. Let's see how well Boss can go. Got to make those nice tight turns, which he does effectively. Now through the tunnel for the first time.
Big dog, this covers the ground very well. Long striding, he's very deceptive. He's, I think, in with a good chance. 15 seconds as he goes into the weaves.
And look at that, beautifully done. Just looking for a bit of guidance from the handler. Dave gets it right and now really has to fly through these tunnels. Is it going to be on? Gets it right on the seesaw. Seesaw was down before he left it, which it has to be. Two to clear, it's going to be just outside, but that's a very good round again. 34.498. And that puts Dave Munnings with that clear round into third place.
Great speed, that dog having to make sure he gets all those weaving poles and almost perfect seesaw there.
This is another Border Collie, seven-year-old Quincy with Matthew Goodliff from Long Buckby in Northamptonshire. Matthew says that Quincy is just an amazing dog, part of the Team GB winning World Championship team for 2014 and one of many titles through the tunnel and looking to be moving well at this point. Has to really go for broke.
Yes, but unfortunately he's had five on the A-frame, but this pair really love Crufts. They love the atmosphere and the fantastic crowd that's gathering.
What a shame that was. Just came off that A-frame marginally too soon before the paws were on the white section on the downslope, and you can see going really well. This would have been an awesome round. It would have been right up there in contention. 33.572, second fastest time, but I'm afraid to say that marginal infringement.
It was, and still a second slower than Charlotte Harding, who's currently winning the competition. Into that tunnel, picks it up, and a great finish.
Hannah Holdsworth now with Belle, five-year-old working sheepdog from Scunthorpe in Lincolnshire. Hannah says that Belle is an amazing, honest dog. 2015, really successful, winning two championship tickets, competing at Olympia and Crufts, and part of the GB team as well. And they've made a nice start here over the A-frame. Was that marginally too soon? Yes, five faults.
Five faults, had to go for it. This pair have had an absolutely fantastic year, and you can see why. Look at the tightness of that. Now it's a test of confidence as they go into the collapsible tunnel onto the seesaw.
So the very first run is still the leader from Charlotte Harding. This would have been another very good round and a quick time, 34.815. But, and I'm afraid a big but, there were those five faults.
Onto the A-frame, and as you see, didn't make contact with that white area in an effort to try and just get that extra half a second.
This is the only dog now which can deny the title of champion for Charlotte Harding. This is Jackie Tarn with Becca, a nine-year-old working sheepdog from Barnard Castle. She's got to have an awesome round, and Jackie says she's an awesome dog. She's going to have to really fly, and oh dear, dear, dear. It's an elimination, wrong route. And what happened there exactly, Graham?
Unfortunately, she pushed the dog around the wrong side of the jump as we've come off the dog walk. In the last couple of years, it's been commonplace for judges to set courses that go round the back of jumps. Of course, that wasn't around the back of the jump, but I think there was just a little miscommunication there. But this dog has won the certificate this year, done tremendously well. Great handler, great dog, and they'll be very proud to have been here.
So round they go, and Jackie Tarn and Becker complete the round. But victory for Charlotte Harding. And here's the elimination, Graham.
Yes, unfortunately, as you can see, three was the correct direction. They should have taken it from that direction, pushed it round the back. But it's been a great, great competition. I know this is your first year here at Crufts, John, and watching agility up with me. And I hope you've enjoyed it.
Massively. Charlotte Harding, she was the fastest with Scandal, 32.522. Athleticism, just brilliant to watch. And the Border Collie, she came home for her, the winner, and in second place was Bonnie Quick with Hayley, 34.64. A good second place, but what a round that was from Charlotte Harding. presentations to be made now for our agility champions, small, medium and large dogs. Steve Croxford, vice chairman of the Kennel Club, is going to be making the presentations. He'll be escorted on by Maurice Cook, the Director of Ability, Obedience and Events here at Crufts. And great to see the big crowd in here once more. It's been wonderfully supported right the way through the week. And of course, so many people in here wanting to get a glimpse of these championship performances. And of course, later on, we will see who is going to be the champion overall. Who's going to be the supreme champion?
Well, very exciting. And here comes the presentation party led by Mr. Dave Jolly, who does a fantastic job over the 4 days looking after the ring party and generally managing things in the ring. And they've done a fantastic job this year.
Dogs really enjoy competing in agility. And you can see now they're all excited and knowing that they've had a wonderful adventure. And these were the best of the lot. So Steve Croxford, vice chairman of the Kennel Club, to give the awards, the rosettes and the commemorative crystal. And the winner of the small dogs was Bernadette Bay.
And Steve Croxford just making a presentation to the championship judge as he moves now towards the winner of the small category.
Roger Griffin was our judge and did a splendid job as well. Roger from Maidenhead in Berkshire. And also a big round of applause for all the volunteers who've given up 4 days to make sure that it all goes smoothly. Well done to them. So all set for the presentation, and the winner of the small agility championship was Bernadette Bay with Zaz. And second place, Lucy Osborne with Fling. The medium champion, what a performance it was from Natasha Wise. She's just waiting. She'll be given that presentation now. Perhaps one of the happiest faces we've seen right the way through the week, when her border collie came home as the winner. Second place was Dolly with Rebecca Sargent. Now the winner of the agility championship for large dogs. What an outstanding round it was from Scandal and handler Charlotte Harding. And second place, not far behind, was Bonnie Quick, with Hayley taking the runners-up spot. So they're our agility champions for 2016. Well done to one and all. And they will be going off on a lap of honour shortly. And the crowd giving their appreciation for some just brilliant performances, outstanding dogs and superb handlers. These are the best of the best.
What a cracking championships. And I know this is going out all around the world, and it's a brilliant showcase for British agility. And it was fantastic entertainment.
Coming up, we have another presentation to the FCI large team, winning the Agility World Cup last year. And what a performance it was. The last team gold was way back in 2003. But for Greg Derrett, Matthew Goodliff, Jess Clairhue and Charlotte Harding, wow.
Yeah, not for the first time this week. I'm really excited and very proud. To achieve winning a world championship title in the large dog team at the world championships last year in Bologna was just an absolutely amazing feat, and everybody in this country is so proud. And you'll see that the team is now actually been led out by Mark Laker. Mark Laker is the manager of Agility Team GB for the Kennel Club, took over from me in 2012, and he has done the most amazing job with the team, with him and his support crew.
Congratulations now down in front of our commentary position to be given by Simon Luxmore, chairman of the Kennel Club, and his vice chairman, Steve Croxford. These are very, very special dogs with the best of handlers. This is some achievement.
It is, and Steve Croxford himself is a former Great Britain team manager, so he knows exactly what it's like. And as you say, they've got a small presentation, I believe, is going to be made to them in recognition of an absolutely fantastic feat. Greg Derrick receiving his medal. And congratulations. Charlotte Harding just won the championship. Jessica Clairhue and Matthew Goodliffe with Quincy.
Well done to them. Proud moment for them, receiving their awards in front of this big crowd here in Birmingham at the NEC, the FCI Large Team World Champions. They are the team who took the gold in Italy. And what a big smile from the manager. Very richly deserved.
They are, and they've continued to achieve well since then. And I think they're going to be right in the mix. If they get in the squad and make the team again this year, they're going to be a big threat to them. Watch out. Here we come, Europe.
Team GB. Appreciated as they should be.
And we are delighted to welcome PC Martin Taylor and...